Gauri Lankesh was a unique journalist. Whenever she interviewed all of us in the People's Movement, the depth was unique. And she, coming from her father's tradition, has been writing with a clear progressive position and condemning everything that is casteist, communal or discriminatory. And that is why she is killed. So it is the murder of democracy, diversity, freedom, equity, everything that was in the ideology of Gauri Lankesh. And the society that is standing now by the same ideology needs to be saluted. It's only this that would give protection to all the whistleblowers, all those who feel free, confident and courageous to express their opinion against the present communal politics.
We need to identify the climate of hate and bigotry which is propagated by those in power in the center as well as organizations of the Sangh Parivar, which are creating a climate that has led to this murder. And that is what we are here to protest against. Because if we don't raise our voice against this, then we are allowing our country to be turned into a fascist country, which is why an undemocratic country, which is why we are here to speak out against the series of killings of Dabolkar, Pansare, Kalburgi, now Gauri Lankesh. And Gauri was a bold voice who refused to be intimidated by the bullets. We are all here to say we also will not be intimidated by the threats, by the online threats, offline threats, by the bullets, none of that. None of that. So we are here to speak up for unity, for peace, for communal harmony, and for all the things that Gauri stood for.
Pluralism and secularism is not a foreign construct. It is a construct deep into the soils of this country, and nobody, no majoritarian fascist can take that away. No majoritarian fascist bullets can take it away. They are cowards who kill like that. We have lost many to such cowards' bullets, but all that have gone, including Gauri, have been brave shining stars. Spoken truth to power. Gone against the wind. Personally and politically, she stood apart. All of us have a lot to learn from her. If nothing else, the clarity, the grace, the conviction that exclusions and deprivals of all kinds need to unite. And we can't afford to be sectarian under our individual flags. We must dedicate Gauri's death to a renewal of a cohesive resistance. We cannot let her go in vain.